ما صارت بأس محمد الرسول في تبعث الرقم محمد واتي لك لتقفل هذا الرد بالله رب المسلم دي صلى الله من أبدا وعلى وصحبه صلى الله عليه وسلم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إن الحمد لله إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستهديه إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستهديه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا إنه من يهده الله فهو المهتدي ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمد عبده ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه وحبيبه أشهد أنه قد بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة ومع الغمة وجاهد في الله حق جهاده حتى أتاه اليقين فصلاة وسلام على عبدك ونبيك محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا. يقول الله سبحانه وتعالى بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن هدى للناس وبينات من الهدى والفرقان. ويقول رسول صلى الله عليه وسلم من صام رمضان ثم أتبعه ستا من شوال كان كصيام الدهر، وفي رواية من صام رمضان ثم أتبعه ستا من شوال فكأنما صام الدهر، أو كما قال عليه الصلاة والسلام. أما بعد، all praise to Allah. All praise to Allah, the one, the only, the one who should be worshipped. I bear witness that He is the creator of this universe and He is the one who should be worshipped. I bear witness that Muhammad alayhi salatu wassalam is His messenger. True mercy sent to us. If we follow His path, inshallah, we'll be in Jannah. Amma ba'd, Ramadan came and Ramadan gone. And subhanallah, I said before Ramadan this will happen. And really, I have my proof. I'm almost now 60 and still how many Ramadans I saw and they're gone. But the problem of Ramadan, it goes much faster than any other month. I'm not sure why. It goes very fast, very fast. And always I give this example of someone, you know, a rich man, and he has a bank in his house and he tells you, go in, get the money, any money you want, you have 2 hours. Pick all the money out and then it's yours. Any money you get from the bank, it's yours. From my private bank. And you go in the house and you look around. Oh, that's beautiful. You have 2 hours. Get the money. Oh, this is baklava. Let's try it. You have the money. Get the money. I like the bed. Let me sleep for 15 minutes to enjoy the royal king. But get the money. Open the fridge. Get the money. He's giving you free money, get it? This is Ramadan. Free hasanat. Simple things, and Allah even gave you a hint. He chained all Satans. That's why it's easy for any of us in Ramadan to read the Quran, come and pray, and everything. After Ramadan, wallahi, before, even the last day of Ramadan, all the bad thoughts start to come to me again. Oh, he's sending messages now to me. Before even Ramadan ends, he starts sending you messages. And imagine now, our shaitan, by the way, if you don't know, every one of us has his own shaitan. His own and his own angel. Every one of us. The angel is telling you the truth, whatever good, and the shaitan is telling you whatever bad. And by the way, your shaitan is expert in you. He's assigned to you when you're born. And he goes away when you die. The same with the angel, by the way. And subhanAllah, he knows you inside out. And when you go to sleep, he doesn't go to sleep. He goes to the head, Satan himself. What should I do? You know, consultation. What should I do? Now, back again to after Ramadan. What should we do after Ramadan? Ramadan is gone. 10 days now and Ramadan is gone. I have some points I need to share with you. First, Ramadan is a visitor, and the visitor has to go. That's life. Visitor has to go. The owner will go. How about the visitor himself? And it shows you that if he goes, we will go. Get ready to that day. Any of us are ready? I don't think so. I'm not ready. Why? Sayyidina Ali said, إِنَّ السَّفَرَ طَوِيلٌ. The distance from the grave to the Jannah is long. Imagine one day is equal to 50,000 years. One day. How about the rest? One day, 50,000 years. أصحاب في يوم كان مقداره 50,000 سنة. One day. What do you have food? When you go to a trip, I'm going now to New York or New Jersey or Texas. You get some food, you know, plan yourself. What's your plans? This is the first point. Get ready. We are leaving. Second thing. When Ramadan comes, everyone is happy. You know, the first day in Ramadan, this mosque was full to the door. Wallahi, I'm scared in Ramadan in the first and second day and third day. And Ramadan is gone after that. Ramadan ends and comes back last 10 days. And it's hard on the 27th. Subhanallah, and we're done. Ramadan. Subhanallah. This is how Ramadan works. But did you enjoy it? Did you grab it? That's the question to every one of us. Ramadan is for you or for against you? Like a witness. Ramadan is like a witness to any of us. Did you enjoy it? Did you work on it? Or you just stopped eating and drinking and that's about it? That's about it. I'm not eating. I'm not drinking. And did you grab anything of Ramadan? Did you control your anger problem? Control your smoking problem? Control your drinking problem? Control your woman problem? Control your seeing the opposite sex problem? Everyone, by the way, has a problem. It's okay. It's not bad to have a problem. It's bad that you know it and you don't solve it. It's bad that you know it and you don't solve it. Everyone has weakness. Every one of us. But what's your plans to fix it? What's your plan to fix it? The next one, Ramadan, you gain some hasanat. Alhamdulillah, all of us, inshallah. May Allah accept it from us, inshallah. After Ramadan, what are you going to do? Let's go. Whatever we missed in Ramadan, let's catch up. Oh, really? You're losing hasanat. You're planning to lose it before even anything? At least give it 6-7 months of stopping whatever you're going to do. And then, I'm not saying start doing sins, but try to work with that. Oh, I'm doing 10 sins. Let's make it 8-7. Reduce the amount of hasanat you're doing, sayyat you're doing. Make the hasanat last more. That's important. Next one is that shaitan, like I said, relaxed in Ramadan. He's not relaxing, by the way. He's very sad that you're grabbing hasanat. Imagine an enemy to you. He sees you getting money and getting wealth and health and whatever. And now he's back. What do you think the first thing he'll do? He will attack left and right. All the thoughts, subhanAllah, I'm telling you, all the thoughts that I was stopping before Ramadan, in Ramadan, came to me the last day of Ramadan. I'm not joking. Came to me and start, you know, messages here and messages there. And after Ramadan, in full power. I know shaitan is here. You see your kids are jumping, your wife is hitting, or your husband is doing bad things. What happened? Oh, shaitan is back. Welcome. I'm telling my kids, shaitan is back. Welcome back. Our best friend is back. Get rid of him. A'udhu billah, a'udhu billah, shaitan rajim, a'udhu billah. And everyone calms down again. But this is the way. Shaitan coming in full force. And he wants to make us lose all the hasanat we gained in Ramadan. Remember, every one of us, we were praying 5 times a day, trying his best to come to the mosque after Ramadan. I have to relax a little bit. I'm tired, you know. I'll try to come one time. Try to come. If you're coming in Ramadan 3-4 times, try to come at least 2 times. One time a day. Try to pass by the mosque and pray, whatever. Very important to keep on the good habits. Oh, this is a good one. Alhamdulillah, we saved the Quran, we removed the dust from it. Inshallah, we'll see you next Ramadan. Tell him bye-bye. See you inshallah next Ramadan. That's how it works. The Mus'haf is only in Ramadan. After that, we keep it there, collecting dust. Alhamdulillah, we're happy. And Ramadan, we use it again. Should we do that? No. This is every day we can use. And they'll tell you the end, the easy way. There is an easy way to use it even outside Ramadan. And let's wait for the end, inshallah. Hopefully, many people will come in and hear what I'm going to say. Remember, in Ramadan, you're coming and saying salam to your brothers here. My brother here and my brother there. Assalamu alaikum, how are you? After Ramadan, still he's your brother. He didn't go away. He's still your brother. Maybe he is the one who will take you to Jannah. You know that? Maybe? In the people of hellfire, they said that some, after everyone goes to hell and heavens, some of the people goes from hell to heaven. And they said, who makes shafa'ah to them? A prophet? A messenger? No. Angel? No. Who said? His friend. He's in Jannah and he said, oh Allah, I cannot enjoy Jannah without my friend. Get a friend that hopefully he will take you to Jannah. Remember that part. And the last one. If you really think that Ramadan, you enjoy Ramadan, see yourself after Ramadan. Are you keeping on the whatever you're doing in Ramadan? From the prayer, to fasting, to giving, to smiling, to say salamu alaikum to everyone you know and you don't know. Saying salam to everyone you know and you don't know. This is the way you show yourself that Ramadan is there for you. Remember, Ramadan is not here for us to go. It's here to stay and to enjoy the whole year. It's a crash course that if you enjoy it, this is the way we control ourselves. The Prophet and his companion used to enjoy Ramadan and enjoy every second of it. And after Ramadan, they stay 6 months after Ramadan thanking Allah that they came to Ramadan. And inshallah, I'll give you an example, inshallah. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لكم فاستغفروا يا فوز المستغفرين. اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا واسرافنا في امرنا لا ملل منه. ان الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه ونعوذ بالله من شرور انفسنا ومن سيئات اعمالنا. اما بعد, I'll give you an example that I just heard when I'm coming in. Talha, this is one of the Ashra Mubashirin Bijannah. He had three of his friends. And the first one, he died as a martyr. And after a year, the second one died as a martyr again, in the sake of Allah. And the third one died after them, 2 years after, on his bed. And one day he saw a dream that the hereafter came. And subhanAllah, he saw his friend who died in his bed. They told them, the three, go to Jannah. The three of them, go to Jannah. And Talha saw the first one who died on his bed is first in front of them. And then the second, and then the third. And he was shocked. The one who's fought in the sake of Allah is the last one, and then the second. And then the one who's died in his bed is the first to come in to Jannah. Does it make sense? And he went to the Prophet والسلام, and he told them that, the dream. He said to him the meaning of, why you're confused? Why you're confused? The last one, Allah prolonged his life. He enjoyed Ramadan more. He prayed more. He did more things and good deeds. This elevated him more. خيركم من طال عمره وحسن عمله. The best of you is the one whose life is prolonged and he's doing good deeds. He attended Ramadan. أن رمضان أن رمضان أن ليلة القدر and not only ليلة القدر. By the way, everyone is I want to hate ليلة القدر and I said it before here. You're aiming for ليلة القدر and you have every night that your name can be released from the hellfire. Every night, it's better than ليلة القدر. I believe ليلة القدر will give you 83 years. If one night your name is not is removed from the list of hellfire, what do you want? Your name is not there anymore. You're going to Jannah. Got it? Ramadan is there to enjoy. If you have this mentality that Ramadan is there for us to enjoy, it's different thing. Now, what should we do after Ramadan? I wrote 7 points. Hopefully, all of us will do all of them. If you can do one or two, it's okay. Let's see. One, you keep on the good deeds. Keep on doing whatever you're doing, good deeds. Prayer, fasting, smiling, saying salamu alaikum to your brothers. When you come to your home, instead of saying hi, saying salamu alaikum, bismillah, salamu alaikum. When you shake your wife, or kiss her, by the way, it's okay to shake your wife's hand, by the way. Don't take it, I'm giving you a fatwa now. You can shake your wife's hand and say salamu alaikum to her. It's good to do that. Do that. She's your wife. You don't have to tell Jessica in the work, good morning, Jessica. No. You can say it, but your wife is more important. Your kids, hug them and kiss them. They need that. Two, try to fast six days of Shawwal. Like I said in the hadith, man sama Ramadan, thumma atba'ahu sittum shawwal. Why? The ulama are saying that if you fast month of Ramadan, and the hasanah minimum, the hasanah is 10. Then 1 month equal 10 months. And 6 days after that is 60 days. This is 12 months. Every year you fast 6 days after Ramadan, it's equal. You meet Allah fasting your whole life. Do I have to fast these days continuous? No. Do I have to fast them one by one? Yes. Anytime. Should I fast in Shawwal only? Some of the ulama even said no. But it's better to, because the hadith said, من صام رمضان ثم أتبعه ستة من شوال. Then it's preferable to do it in شوال, as the hadith saying. Because still, your body is ready. Fast Monday and Thursday, fast Saturday and Sunday, fast any 2 days in the week, or 1 day in the week. You'll hit 4 weeks, and then you can fast after that. It's up to you. Do whatever you like, thinking you're right. Three, I believe everyone here prayed Taraweeh with us this year, hopefully. And not only that, you prayed 8, or if you go to Isna, it's 20, or you go, up to you. After Isha, every day, let's pray 2 rak'ah. 2 rak'ah only. 2 rak'ah after Isha, with niyyah of Tahajjud, Qiyam Layl, I'm staying at night. And I'll add one more to it, which I wrote here. When you stand reading this 2 rak'ah, hold the mushaf, get it from there, clean the dust from it, with niyyah that you read the Quran and open it. How far can I read? 1 safha. Is it hard? 1 safha takes less than 2 minutes. Wallahi, it takes, for me, it takes less than 2 minutes. 1 safha. If you're good, 2 safha. Whatever you like. This means that you try to finish, if you do that 2 safha every day, you will finish the Quran before Ramadan, next Ramadan. Simple. You need a khatma? There is a khatma. Every night, finish 2 safha, 600 pages, 300 days. You're done Ramadan. Before Ramadan, you'll finish the mushaf. Oh, but can I read the Quran in the PS? We did that. The sheikh was reading the Quran in the mushaf. He can, in Taraweeh. But our sheikh is hafiz. But anyway, the people behind him was holding the Quran. Can I read it from the phone? Yes. You can read it anywhere. In any sunnah, by the way, you can hold the mushaf and read. Have a covenant with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that I will, in Aisha prayer, I'll do that. I'm doing it, for example, in Duha. I pray Duha 2 rak'ah or 4 rak'ah. I hold the mushaf. Why not? Who's stopping you from doing anything? In any sunnah, you can hold the mushaf and start reading. Think about it. But have it as a habit. And don't blame yourself, oh, I missed it today. It's okay. Do it tomorrow. Don't blame yourself to stop. Because the shaitan will come and ask you to blame yourself so you can stop. Don't stop. Next day I'll read. I don't have time, I have to go to work. Half a page. I don't have time, I have to go to work. 2 ayah. You have to read something. With even if you read Qulullah Wahad or Al-Asr, 3 ayat. Hold the Mus'haf, 3 ayat. From any surah. And I suggest that you write it like I'm doing. In Duha, I'm reading. I'm now in Yusuf. I read Yusuf, ayah 4, ayah 10, ayah 20. Keep on doing it. Everywhere I go, I'm in this in Duha. I'm this in at night. Have a plan. The next one. Remember, I said fasting in six of Shawwal. There's another sunnah. You can fast 3 days every month. 13, 14, 15. Every month. Or Monday and Thursday every month. It's up to you. Or Monday only, or Thursday only. It's a training course for you. You keep on doing that. Next, read the Quran like I said. I said combine the Quran with the sunnah of thing. And you can hold the Quran. The last thing I can tell you, donate. I always tell everyone, remember in Ramadan, you donated a lot. Alhamdulillah. May Allah bless everyone who donated and give him more than he wants. But the question is, how about the rest of the year? Try always to donate at least $1, $2. Any mosque. When I go to any mosque in the world, some money, some dollars there. Even if I go to Egypt, pounds. Put some pounds. Pakistan, whatever the umla is, I don't know it. In India, in anywhere, you're praying in this mosque, $1. The least thing you can do. Put something there. Why? Because you don't know which of the donation will take you to Jannah. Because like I always say, when you donate, now you are a shareholder of the place. You are a shareholder of the place. All the hasanat done in this place until the hereafter, until the end of the world, you have a share in it. Imagine now you have a share in this mosque, in Texas, in India, in Pakistan, in Egypt, in Syria, anywhere. And this mosque stays forever until the end of the world. We will die and the hasanat are coming to you. You die and subhanAllah, hasanat is still moving to you. And you say, why is the hasanat coming? You're a shareholder in this mosque. You paid $1 in this mosque. You have some hasanat coming to you. Remember, Ramadan is a training course and this means that we have to enjoy it and use it. If you don't use it, you lose it. How many times we learn something? I learned French when I was in university. I cannot speak maybe one sentence in French anymore. I don't use it. I use English. Even now, Egyptian, even though when I go to Egypt, they know that I'm not from Egypt. They have their own slangs. If you don't use it, you lose it. The same with Ramadan. The same with Ibadah. If you don't keep on capitalizing on what you learn in Ramadan, you lose it. That's how it works. I know that I cannot do 8 rakah, I cannot fast all month. It's okay. Shaitan was away, alhamdulillah, alhamdulillah. Shaitan was away, subhanallah, and now he's back. He's trying to stop us from doing good things. Do what? Make the minimum. If you go more than a minimum, perfect. But at least do something. I'm doing because I did it in Ramadan. I'm praying 2 rakah because I did it in Ramadan. I'm doing this because I did it in Ramadan. Connect. You know, you connect. You know the passport? The same idea with the passport. I'm Canadian. What does it mean, the passport? The blue passport. I'm Canadian. I'm Egyptian. I'm Pakistan, and so on. It's the connection. Remember that. Remember Ramadan. It was there. And pray that Allah will accept what we did. And Allah will make us reach the next Ramadan. اللهم اهدنا في من هديت. اللهم اهدنا في من هديت. وعافنا في من عافيت. اللهم اجمعنا ولا تفرقنا. اللهم اجمعنا ولا تفرقنا اللهم اغفر لنا ولوالدينا وللمسلمين اجمعين اللهم انصر إخواننا في فلسطين، اللهم انصر إخواننا في فلسطين، اللهم وثبتهم يا رب العالمين، اللهم ثبتهم يا رب العالمين، اللهم تقبل شهداءهم، اللهم تقبل شهداءهم، اللهم تقبل شهداءهم، اللهم اغفر لهم يا رب العالمين، اللهم اطعم جائعهم واسقع عطشانهم، واغفر لنا ولهم يا رب العالمين، واغفر تقصيرنا يا رب العالمين، اللهم انصر جميع المسلمين في كل بقاع الارض يا رب العالمين، وانشر السلام يا رب العالمين، واخر دعوانا الحمد لله رب العالمين، وقوموا الى صلاتكم ارحمكم الله واقيموا الصلاه.
الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على
الفلاح لا لا بسيط
الله أكبر الله
لا بسيط
لا إله إلا الله
استو ترسوا اعتدلوا أيضا نزل بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الله أكبر اللهم بعد بينا ونقنين من الثنوب والغدر من الثنوب والغدر من الثنوب والغدر بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين سبح اسم ربك الأعلى الذي خلق فسوى والذي قدر فهدى والذي أخرج المرعى فجعله غثاء أحوى سنقرئك فلا تنسى إلا ما شاء الله إنه يعلم الجهر وما يخفى ونيسرك لليسرى فذكر إن نفعت الذكرى سيذكر من يخشى ويتجنبها الأشقى الذي يصلى النار الكبرى ثم لا يموت فيها ولا يحيا قد أفلح من تزكى وذكر اسم ربه فصلى بل تؤثرون الحياة الدنيا والآخرة خير وأبقى إن هذا لفي الصحف الأولى صحف إبراهيم وموسى الله أكبر سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين والعصر إن الإنسان لفي خسر إلا الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات وتواصوا بالحق وتواصوا بالصبر الله أكبر سمع الله لمن حمده اللهم لك الحمد حتى ترضى اللهم لك الحمد إذا رضيت اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على عبدك ونبيك محمد في الأولين
اللهم تقبل منا رمضان، اللهم تقبل منا رمضان، اللهم تقبل منا رمضان. اللهم اغفر لإخواننا في فلسطين، اللهم اغفر لهم وارحمهم وثبتهم يا رب العالمين. اللهم إنا ندعو لهم يا رب العالمين فتقبل. وآخر دعوانا الحمد لله رب العالمين. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر.
الصلوات الطيبة السلام.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. استغفر الله العظيم. استغفر الله العظيم. استغفر الله العظيم. استغفر الله العظيم. اللهم عيني على ذكرك وشكرك وحسن عبادك. اللهم السلام والسلام على رسول الله.